Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Gavinsky's Tutorials. Today I'm going to do a walkthrough of Bleass Tides. So, nice new delay plugin from Bleass with a few really cool features. So, let's first just go through a few presets and take a look at the UI. Now, I don't know if it's like this on desktop, but I find the UI very unresponsive. Like, here I'm tapping on delay and it's just not switching over. It seems to take a long time after a preset's loaded for that to calm down. It's getting a little bit faster there, but... So, what we've got here is two main sections. And again, it's just taken forever to switch over to the delay section. So we have the delay section with an input filter. And here, the delay section, where you have a choice between a tape-style delay and a cross-faded delay. So the tape-style delay, when we change the time, let me just set this to free mode here. I could do it in sync as well, mind you, but... So here, you can hear that we're getting pitch changes, right? As we would in a tape delay. And here, with this inertia knob value, we're just changing how quickly the time changes can actually take effect. But then if we change to crossfade mode, here we can change the delay time, but the pitch will not change. And so in this mode, the inertia knob controls the speed of the crossfades. So let's see what that's like down at zero. Right, so better with a bit of this dialed in. The offset can adjust the delay time a little bit to make it a little bit more natural, less robotic. And you have a ping pong section here with two modes, classic and symmetric. So in classic, the number of overall repeats created is the same as when the ping pong is disabled. This is according to the manual. In symmetric mode, each channel produces the same number of repeats as when ping pong is disabled, resulting in twice the number of repeats overall. I like how that's sounding. So then here we've got the feedback and dry and wet, and you can also freeze things. So it will stop taking new input and just freeze whatever the last input into the delay was. Let's jump on to another preset. So again, taking some time really for the UI to update here. Let me see if I can... I'm tapping here on feedback. A little bit sluggish for sure. Now, note, by the way, there's a randomizer, and the manual says that that's calibrated in a way that the results will be musical. And there's undo and redo, so great! Randomizer and undo and redo. Now, another thing here is you can tap to change the pitch of the delay. So tapping on this side, that will lower it, and the further over to the left you tap, the lower it will go. And if you tap more towards the center left, it's going to be a smaller downwards adjustment. And then tapping over here, this will increase the pitch, and again getting a bigger increase as you go over to the right. So that's pretty cool, isn't it? You can also drag. So that's it on the crossfade mode. That's how it sounds when I do that. Let's see on the tape mode. Bring this feedback down a little bit. So that's dragging over on the right side. Let's now try dragging on the left. So also with the input filter, by the way, you can drag the nodes. Again, though, very slow responsiveness here. Or you can adjust things with these. Okay, let's jump on. Now, we have a modulation section here, so we can have up to three LFOs and various controls regarding the waveform type and whether it's free or synced. And look here, there's a button for no triplets and stuff. Other controls, free rate, phase, offset, and smoothing. Here we can change the shape of the waveform a bit. And we have two envelope followers. And again, slow responsiveness here, a little macro knob. So all of these, you can set up various destinations, right? So here, for example, we're looking at LFO2, and we can have up to four destinations and choose here what it's modulating. And dial in the amount here. And this looks pretty cool. I don't remember seeing this in anything else before. We got this times 0.01 button, and that will divide the amount by 100. So you're getting much more subtle modulations. So let's just try sending this to the delay. Let's just say to the free time. And so with this button on, it should be pretty subtle. That's lovely. And that's with that button off. That's that on again. So you have four destinations. Now let's jump on to the next preset. And so there's a whole other page that we haven't looked at yet, which is Feedback FX. So here we can set up to five different effects at different points in the delay line. So presumably this, you know, placed before the bit crusher, and so you could change it so you have the bit crusher first and then this dust thing. So we have distortion, dust, bit crushing, frequency shifter, pitch shifter, ring modulator, delay, Dendragon, high pass filter, low pass filter, band pass, and peak filter. So let's just keep it on the FX page as we go through some presets and see what we've got. So here, ring mod going into distortion and into peak filter. And we have these settings we can adjust. Jumping on to the next one. That's lovely. So distortion going into bandpass, filter, high pass, low pass, delay. So you can put a second delay in. I love the new UI, by the way. Getting a little stutter effect here. Using the sample and hold LFO on synced time. Very nice. Wow, it's really slow response time, I must say. I'm loving this so far, but I really don't like the slow responsiveness. I don't know if it's like that on desktop. So, you get the idea there. Let me just tap on this and see how many presets we've got. I've tapped, but because of the slow response time, it's just not opening. Okay. So, wow, there are a lot of presets, a lot. Let's just try the randomizer a few times more and see what it comes up with. I've pressed it already, just waiting for it to kick in. There we go. So on this visualizer, by the way, the white dots represent the input and the blue dots represent repeats. Lovely little visualizer. What an interesting effect, but really this, I don't know if other people and other devices, I mean, I'm using a good iPad, it's an M1 iPad Pro. The only other plugin I can think of recently that I found the UI so slow to interact, or sorry, to update, is another desktop port, Clave Grand OneShot. Very slow to update, and I also really like that plugin, but both that and this really need some improvement in this area. I don't know if this is what other people are experiencing. So, hope that was useful for you, everybody. If it was, please smash the like, etc. And I'll see you in the next video. Take it easy.